Li Lim Cho, born in 1909, was an important icon in the history of Taiwanese popular music. The song, Craving for the Spring Breeze, was his best-known work, composed at the age of 25 in his residence.
Taiwan 流行音乐产生之后最成功的，当然就是首推《望春风》，到现在都成为是我们土地文化经典歌曲之一，好，算是最重要的。
After Li Lim Cho graduated from elementary school, he worked as an accountant to support his family. By chance, he was in charge of the cinema's film promotions and writing lyrics for the movie advertising song. His composing life thus began. His residence hid in these ordinary red brick houses. You may never discover.
一般来讲是都要对乡邻讲起，阮应拜对乡邻是做米家，但是阮阿公共保林共背书，所以财产互过了了。阮阿嬷来找陈天来，因为陈天来是阮阿嬷的阿叔、二叔，所以讲阮阿嬷的老爸就是陈天来大兄。来个讲啊，你一间怎啊大？
就大稻埕这边传统的店屋特色，四柱三窗的砖木构造的一个特色，所以在里面我们有看到七里庵式的这个隔间，那也有红砖的，然后还有竹编泥墙的隔间，然后杉木隔间。然后有半楼，也就是我们说的阁楼。
Released in 1933, the song "Craving for the Spring Breeze" indicated Li Lim Cho's wish to encourage women to express their emotions bravely.
阮老爸咧写作的时阵，讲伊写作有三个要点，讲了三个要点就头一个，当然坚心也坚哦，是较袂向拍断落这個、这个算讲灵感哦。第二个呢，讲啉烧酒哦，烧酒啉落去哦，灵感在下，敢若用烧酒啉落去，笔在点头，夜来向人偏着哦，就敢若咧酒家安尼先哦。
However, as Li Lim Cho and his wife passed away one after another, the residence of this significant lyricist in Taiwanese history later was involved in debt issues of the Li family, facing the crisis of being foreclosed in 2020.
When there was a media came to Taiwan, I said, I'm going to leave. If you want to leave this house, I'm going to leave. I'm going to leave all the money out of here, from Beijing, from here.我另外重新开张就好，但是文化局吼，伊讲你唔能安尼先，安尼做先咯，都无迄个原汁原味迄个味道的。还有讲啊，安尼你怎样吼，甲买落来。
那老师当时也来找过我，那我也鼓励老师说，对，我们应该把它标下来，因为老师已经花了3000多万去买一楼，哎，那个是真的是天价。所以没有钱修理啊，那还好文化局也协助李老师，就拿到了这个中央的补助，再加上文化局自己也补助他们，很幸运的就是说这一项一项的困难都已经克服了，当然就是还有最后一里路啦，未来的经营管理啦。
讲到这个要变怎使用这个空间的时阵哦，我来登记给阮老爸上早的时阵，伊就一个 idea 是安怎个？伊讲哦，咱一般新人就是讲新出道的人对无，无机会，无迄个舞台，无平台哦，通好发表伊作品。所以就是讲，楼卡在做啥物？公共艺术表演空间，要做这个导览的意义在吼，让大家了解讲啊，阮老爸伊创作的迄个足迹，踮咧各无同的所在吼，伊活动个。
你也了解你家己的土地，你就会。爱你家己的文化了，所以你也对对这吼、哦，跟每一寸土地那些历史故事，那个趣味的。
因为阮老爸迄阵啊，伊在生的时候就讲过，文化的物件吼，都要保留。你若卡掉就无去啊，啊那钱吼，钱搁赚就有啊。
Songs always carry memories. When this spring breeze blows through Da Dao Cheng, listen carefully. People like us may still hear the voice of that era after centuries.